Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our second presentation. It's not about the province. It is about Mekong River. Please welcome Miss Seanghy.
And I would like to introduce myself. My name is Seanghy. I'm a hospital that teaches students of one. I would like to tell you about geography, Cambodian Mekong, population, Mekong fish, biodiversity, Mekong rivers, needs and advantages. The Mekong River flows 4,800 from Tibet through China, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, the Vietnam Delta, and into the south of China Sea, draining an area of 795,000 square kilometers. And we also call this brand name by a country that in China they call Lan Kam Chan, mean Tunle Rung Chul, Myanmar and Thailand call Mel Nam Kung, mean Mae Tuk, and Cambodia call Tunle Thong, and Vietnam call Bulung, it means Nek Lam Buon. It's currently one of the least modified large rivers and second most biodiverse river in the world after the Amazon. Flow in the Mekong River. Mekong are naturally controlled by the second tropical monsoon. The current pattern and variation of water flows in the Mekong River are critical to sustaining fishery, agriculture, ecosystem, as well as the culture of people in the basin. The river supports the world's largest freshwater fishery and the largest million people dependent on deep flow. And also deep flow are at risk of being significantly altered through extensive ongoing development and plan of hydropower in mainstream and distributary water abstraction for agriculture and climate change. The Mekong River passes Cambodia about 500 kilometers from the border with Laos in the north and Vietnam in the south, and it has an average width of about 1.5 kilometers in the territory of Cambodia. In rainy season, Mekong River infills water from May to October, and water was flowed out from the river to Tunle Sak Lake. In transition water, disappear from November to April, and water flow back from Tunle Sap into the river. The Mekong River flows through five provinces. There are Seng Krai, Krati, Kampong Cham, Kandan, and Krai Bay. But in Phnom Penh, this big river flows into four bay that we call Chak Mok River. And please move on. About population, Cambodian people are living along Mekong River and building their house close to each other. Along the Mekong area, the land are good fertilizer for growing. So all the residents who live there, mostly they plant the tree to get fruit for it and growing vegetables along the river like corn, beans, and more. In rainy season, people transplant rice, follow the water, and fishing is one of the activities of people do for support the family, selling, and for export also. Besides this, the people who live along the river, they around blanket and it's and put Namaskar. Mekong is the high species reaches around 1,100 fish species, 20,000 plant species, 430 mammals, 1,200 birds, 800 reptiles and amphibians. But some fish are almost destroyed by the people and also the pollution of water. The Mekong River produces around 2.6 million ton fish per year and the value of Mekong fish catch are $2,000 million per year. And fish are caught by different countries every year, such as China, 25,000 ton equal 1%, Laos, 180,000 ton equals 1%. Cambodia, 680,000 equals 25%. Thailand, 930,000 pounds equals 35%. And Vietnam, 840,000 pounds equals 32%. For transportation, for hundreds of years, the Mekong River has been a vital passing way for people and goods. Today, the Mekong River is still a essential means of transportation for many of people living in the region and play an increasingly important role in international trade and tourism. About the Mekong River's disadvantage and advantage. The river provides water for agriculture, a good place for growing cultivation and support the fish for people in and outside of the country. But the river flows also destroy house, crops, animals, infrastructure and also the life of human as well. And also, if they do the hydropower on the river, it will be have an advantage and also disadvantage. About advantage, we have a kind of electricity for the people in Cambodia with a cheap price without to buy from another country with an expensive price. And disadvantage, it can make landfall, close out biodiversity, some areas will be destroyed by flooding and some people are forced to leave the ground and it may cause cultivation which can make people